everybody. It's Keith Brown, Tack Room Devotional. Welcome. And we're looking at the 34th Psalm this week. And all I want to do is kind of just break it down. Maybe this will give you an idea of kind of how I do Bible study. You know, I use commentaries and all that kind of stuff, and I kind of look at what other people say, but basically I allow the Holy Spirit to show me what he's trying to do. So we're kind of breaking this down, and again, allowing you to see this Bible study into Psalm 34, written by King David, or by David. Yeah, he was king then too, and wrote this down. And we read it yesterday, so I'm not going to read it again. But let me just read the first three sentences or verses. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Now, this is not words of a person who's always exuberant, always, you know, real high and trying to get you all pumped up. But these are the words of a man who has simply said, I choose by an act of my will to bless the Lord. We talked about it yesterday. David is telling himself, you will bless the Lord. Now, many times, I believe that's how we get started to be in the Spirit. In other words, I got to get my flesh out of the way, so I got to say to my flesh, flesh, you're not doing that anymore. Right now, this is what we're doing, and what we are going to do is praise and worship and bless the Lord our God. And so that's where we want to get. That's the way we want to be. For us to think as Christians that everything is just going to be rosy-posy is kind of a lie. You know, we're going to get into hard times, and this passage here talks about David getting into some hard times. And what does he do? The first thing he does is he runs to God. In verse 18, the psalmist says, if your heart is broken, you'll find God right there. Let's read it from the New King James. It says, the Lord is near to those who have a broken heart and saves such as have a contrite spirit. So when you get into hard times, again, here it is. The Lord's near to those who have a broken heart. Broken heart. In other words, if you're going through something, why in the world wouldn't you want to run to God? And, of course, a contrite spirit. Back then, just as today, there was a pseudo-theology that explained any kind of misfortune as a sign from a divine sign from God, punishing you for something that you've done wrong. That isn't right. God isn't punishing his kids. These things come on us, and what we need to realize is what we do is we run to God in these times when we're having hard times. Why? Because we read here yesterday, as we read through this, that he delivers. Listen to this. Many are the afflictions. This is verse 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. Not some, all. So again, yeah, there's going to be hard times. That's not God trying to teach you a lesson. That's not God, you know, thumping on you because you made a mistake. No, but the troubles, now understand this, what troubles should do is cause us to run to God. Unfortunately, many of us don't, and we need to. We need to use those opportunities when we do come into trials and tribulations and hard times in our lives to run to God and to seek his deliverance, to seek his help in times of need. Amen. The ministry of Jesus was exactly this. He deliberately singled out every kind of trouble and initiated a healing ministry to the sick. He fed the hungry. He delivered those that were oppressed by the devil and all the rest of the thing. He did things in order to set us free. And the Bible says that he is the expressed image of God. So he did that showing and demonstrating to us how God loves us and how God deals with us. Amen. And once again, here's this psalm speaking the same thing. Okay, so we'll pick this up again tomorrow. I want to talk about worship and praise tomorrow as we look into this psalm. Remember, Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek him and serve him.